A while ago, I made a video about Sly Cooper, and it's been my most popular video thus far, so I decided hopefully I can keep the train rolling a bit and get some more views, you know what I mean? Nah, I'm just kidding. Well, sorta. 50% of me is trying to get views, and the other 50% of me just really likes this game and feels the need to just express it to the rest of the world. You see, back in the old days, there were clear mascots for each console. Xbox had the Chief, Nintendo had Mario, Nickelodeon had Big Time Rush, Obama had Care, but there wasn't a clear answer for PlayStation. Some will tell you that it was Ratchet and Clank, others Back and Taxter, but for me, it will always be Sly Cooper. If we were comparing them to basketball players, Matchin' and Blank were Jelly Bean Bryant's son Kobe Beef Bryant, the Black Mamba himself. Back and Taxter would be LeBron James, LBJ, hey, Bronny, what day is it? Taco Tuesday! And Sly Cooper would be MJ the GOAT, clutchness gene in his veins, flu game, two-time three-peat champion, just straight-up GOAT. Sly Cooper always has and always will give me the greatest feeling, I think, in the world. And it's not what you think it is in that regard. It's just feeling like a six-year-old boy still picking my nose, crying anytime someone touched me, you know, kind of style. But honestly, for some reason, whatever it is, this game just makes me feel like a kid. I can't really explain it. It's this indescribable feeling, but I'm sure anyone who was close with video games, especially during their childhood, definitely has that one game that they go back to that's nostalgic, a flash from the past, if you will. Now, I played a lot of video games when I was a kid, so I don't know what it is about this game. Maybe it's the unique cel-shaded art style that makes it look like a comic book, the tremendous voice acting that makes all the characters feel real while also being cartoony, or maybe it's all just the fun, wacky, wild adventures that our characters go through. You play as Sly Cooper, world-class thief that is also a raccoon. You have your two homies, my boy Bentley and Murray, and you try to, you know, steal some shit. But you're more like a Robin Hood kind of thief instead of a poopy-faced villain. Now, while this game is a linear story platforming game, it's actually a little bit open world, you feel me? You can't drive around and steal cars and kill hookers like GTA or use your goddamn space powers to roam around the world like Saints Row 4, but you can still go around the world, explore to get clue bottles so you can get more powers, or just kill people and get coins to also get more powers. You see, in this game, there's these multiple worlds that you go through. For example, you got the snow world in northern Canada, led by Jean Bazin. You have the illegal spice-making facility in India, led by Rajan. Lots of Jeans. There's also the Prague super prison run by a spider lady, the Contessa. Not a Ja in there, but pretty much the same. There are so many other cool creative worlds to go on, but I can't think of all of them because they're just all so memorable. The gameplay consists of stealth elements and also parkour, so you know it's pretty cool. You basically just go around the map being a fucking thief. What'd you think this was? Some sort of action movie Call of Duty campaign where you Rambo style? No, bitch. Everything in this game isn't climbable like Assassin's Creed, but for the most part, you can get around to the top of every building. You actually gotta be a thief in this game. You can't just be attacking people left and right. You actually gotta be sneaky. I like to tell people that this game is like a Assassin's Creed, but if it was fun and creative. The game is limited to story missions, and yes, some of them are annoying and repetitive, like the surveillance missions in Sly 2, and some of them are just plain annoying, like the stupid freaking water bug level in that India thing that will never shut the hell up. But for the most part, the unique worlds that you go through give the developers the ability to create really cool and interesting missions, like in Sly 3 when you're in China, and the only way to get access into this building is by using Bentley's nerd grappling camera thing and then doing some master code hacking shit to gain access. There's also the boss fight that's later on in that same world, where you fight General Tsao, Chicken, and leader of the Chinese bad guys. In this one boss fight, which is, you fight on this ancient fighting ground, on these like bamboo sticks like your Kung Fu Panda. But here's the cool thing, you're not just jumping from bamboo stick to bamboo stick while trying to hit your enemy, you can fucking fly. Yeah, you can fly across the map, and you wanna know why? It's because all of the energy built up from all the past battles in this area has made it so, like, fucking gravity just doesn't work anymore. You can just fly around. Like, yeah, it's stupid, but it's so cool, creative, and cartoony. I just love it. It's just a perfect example of the creativeness and innovativeness that the game developers will go to make this game unique. The point I'm trying to make here is the game is as fun as Donkey Doodles, whatever that means. And even though the game is silly and wacky, like the time Murray dresses up as Japanese thingamajig and he's wearing his kimono, it's kind of weird. The story ultimately leads you to truly care for your characters, and by the end of the journey, you're glad that they survived, but sad that it's over and that you can't play anymore. Now, sure, the newest installment was subpar to the original three, yes, but even though I didn't like Sly 4 as much, I still found it to be a fun, enjoyable game. Not every game has to be all serious like Assassin's Creed and be all cool. And wow, we're badass because we're realistic. It's like a real world. No, games can be really fun when they're just creative, innovative, and cartoony. And that's probably why this game makes me feel like a kid again. Because of those reasons. So thank you, Sly. Even though your movie and TV show failed, I'm glad I'll always have the memories of loading up my old PlayStation after coming home from school to play some Sly, relax, and go into another world that wasn't all serious, to have fun. And that's what video games are supposed to be.